Welcome to Retro Arcade Reviews. My name is John, and in this episode, we will be reviewing the arcade classic Time Gal. Time Gal is an interactive movie game that was developed by Taito in 1985. In this game, you play as Reika, a time traveler from the future who must prevent the thief Luda from world domination by altering history. You must pursue Luda through several time periods while avoiding or confronting different threats. Navigating it successfully would allow you to progress to the next time period. Fun fact, there are publications that state Reika's appearance was possibly inspired by Lump or Yuri from Dirty Pair. But you know, all anime characters somewhere somehow resemble one another. In FMV games, you watch the animation for visual cues on what actions you must take next. Successfully doing so will result in progressing further in the animation or game. Not inputting the actions in a timely fashion will result in death. There are also moments when you are presented with three options in which you have to choose the right one to progress. One thing I was taken aback by was the date of release of Time Gal. I first played Dragon Slayer in the 90s, and I naturally thought that Time Gal came out around the same period, but Dragon Slayer actually came out in 1983. So these games were pretty old. I've never played Time Gal in the arcade, but I did give it a run through on a Sega CD. In fact, it's because of the Sega CD that I've heard of other Laserdisc games such as Space Ace and Road Blaster. I think what also added to Time Gal's rarity is that the heroine was pretty scantily clad and had some scenes that were, how should I say, a little much for our prudish sensibilities. So naturally, there would be some censorship for the US release. Also, Japanese anime in the 80s wasn't as accepted and mainstream as it is nowadays. So just based on the aesthetic, it would have been a niche market. Arcade games when I was a kid were pretty much everywhere. You can find them at laundromats, candy stores, movie theaters, pool halls, bars, pizza shops, etc. Maybe I missed the whole Laserdisc revolution, but I highly doubt it. Laserdisc games were everywhere. Very, very few places had them because the cabinets were expensive and you usually ran into them in bigger arcades rather than everyday places. Even in the arcades, Laserdisc games were more expensive to play, and if you didn't play them before, you were likely to die fast because the game is pretty much about memorization and reflexes. So I didn't see that many people usually playing it, and if somebody did play it, it was usually a one and done thing. It was more enjoyable to watch somebody playing it rather than playing it yourself. This is because you were so hyper focused on where to move next that it was hard to enjoy the visuals. After a while, believe it or not, you just totally tuned out the visuals and you were basically just looking for the flashes. In my opinion, this pretty much led to the decline of these games in the arcades. There was a brief resurgence of Laserdisc games during the CD era, but it was pretty much short-lived. Nowadays, you can watch the animation from these games online, and I highly recommend it because they are very nicely drawn and animated by reputable animators and studios. So check them out and let me know what you think.